Being a pilot, I've always wanted to fly to the Bahamas and never had the chance to, so today I am flying from Fort Lauderdale to Bimini, and who's the perfect person to guide me but Steve-O!
Let's get this.
Yes!
All right, Captain Mindy, before we leave, we gotta do some shopping.
Yes.
We're gonna go to the Banyan Pilot Shop. Welcome aboard, everybody. Today we have on board Captain Mindy. She's gonna be flying us over to Bimini and then the Bahamas.
Fort Lauderdale Executive Airport, ATIS Information Tango, 1353 Zulu, wind 320 S3. Visibility 10, sky clear, temperature 20, dew point 10, altimeter 3014. ILS, localizer, runway 9 are in use. Landing, departing, runway 9 or runway 13. All fixed wing aircraft contact clearance delivery 127.95 prior to taxi. All aircraft feedback runway hold short instructions and runway assignments with call sign.
All right, we have information Tango. We'll go over to the clearance delivery here at Fort Lauderdale Executive and pick up our clearance.
Good morning, Executive Clearance. Cessna November 774, Charlie Foxtrot over at Banyan with information Tango. We'd like to get our VFR flight flying over to Bimini.
774, Charlie Foxtrot. Did you want radar services to Bimini? If so, request a cruising altitude and aircraft type.
Affirmative, we're at Cessna 182. We'd like to go to 7,500. Direct to Bimini for November 774, Charlie Foxtrot.
November 4, Charlie Foxtrot, maintain VFR departure frequency 119.7, squawk 4654.
We'll maintain VFR, 19.7 departure frequency, squawking 4654, November 774, Charlie Foxtrot.
4 Charlie Foxtrot, Rebecca, correct, ground 0.75, ready to taxi.
Roger, thank you.
All right, we got our clearance. We're going to maintain VFR, direct to Bimini, 19.7 departure frequency, and we'll be squawking 4654.
All right, ready to taxi.
We'll go over to ground, and I'll let them know we're ready to taxi.
Executive ground, good morning. Cessna November 774, Charlie Foxtrot. We're over at Banyan, Bravo 3, and we'd like to taxi with information Tango.
November 774, Charlie Foxtrot. Executive ground, runway 9, or taxi via Bravo Echo, verify if Tango.
We've got Tango, Bravo Echo to runway 9, or November 774, Charlie Foxtrot.
He'll give us the direction which way to go. There we go.
Got it.
We'll be exiting Bravo 3. The friendly folks at Banyan here waving us off. Hey, Banyan's one of my favorite FBOs.
Tango Echoes with you.
They've got the nickname the Gateway to the Bahamas.
Delta Charlie Hotel.
This is Mindy's first time flying to the Bahamas, correct?
First time.
Are you excited?
Yes. Awesome. I'm so excited.
We're gonna do a quick run up here and we'll catch you guys on the other side of this run up. Alright, our run up is complete. Everything checked out good. I'm gonna taxi up here and hold short of the hold short bars. We'll go over to Tyler and let them know we're ready to go.
Second Tower, good morning. November 774, Charlie Foxtrot, holding short of 9.
4 Charlie Foxtrot, runway 9, line up point. Be ready to go. Traffic HonorJet, 3 mile final.
Line up wait, runway 9, we'll be ready to go. November 774, Charlie Foxtrot.
Number 22, Lima, set parking.
All right, we are giving our clearance to line up on the runway and wait.
Lima, continue down the runway, or turn right on runway 13 and contact ground.
Clear to the right. And final's clear. Just have that one here. Just have that one airplane out there in about a 4 mile final.
Northwest Sea Hangars requesting a departure to the west.
4 Charlie Foxtrot, fly straight out. Runway 9, clear for immediate takeoff traffic. HonorJet, 2 mile final.
Clear for me to take off, fly straight out, November 774, Charlie Foxtrot.
All right, so we're full power ready, airspeed's alive, we are in the green, looking for 59 knots.
All righty.
Charlie, with you, Northwest.
There's our 59.
Then we're report 2, Whiskey Charlie Zeta Tower.
This little 182 gets up and goes.
Doesn't it?
Ramp 8, you're going to risk flight westbound. Remain north of runway 9 and north of the
We've got 10 degrees of flaps. Once we get to a safe altitude, we'll pull those out.
All right.
At all times, port to Whiskey Charlie.
And looks good. Pull out our flaps.
Runway Zeta Tower, Roger.
We'll go up to 1,200 feet. I remain clear of Class Charlie airspace.
Port Charlie Foxtrot, contact Mama departure.
Port Charlie Foxtrot, over departure.
You said 1,200?
1,200. That'll keep us clear of the Class Charlie airspace, which is nearby here. So we're over top of us. Morning, Miami, November 774, Charlie Foxtrot, with you climbing 900 to 1,200.
774 Charlie Foxtrot, Miami departure, radar contact, maintain VFR at or below 2,000 and continue eastbound.
We'll continue eastbound and we'll maintain VFR at or below 2,000, November 774 Charlie Foxtrot. All right, now that ATC has given us clearance to climb higher, we can go up to 2,000 feet.
Sounds good.
Which basically puts us where we could now be into Class Charlie airspace.
All right, we'll level off at 2,000 for a little bit.
All right, sounds good. Beautiful day to be flying. We're showing about a 29-minute flight time, correct? 29 minutes?
Yeah, 29 minutes.
A good view of the beach down there.
Yeah, the water's beautiful.
See down to Miami and the left all the way up to Palm Beach.
Yeah, traffic going under our nose. They're about 700 feet below us.
Okay, we'll keep an eye out for him.
7-7-4,
got him in sight.
Continue your climb.
Traffic,
to,
3 o'clock.
3,000.
Climb maintain 3,000. Porsche Charlie Foxtrot. Oh, we got the traffic in sight that went under us. So we're now going to climb up to 3,000.
And we're doing a full power climb with the cowl flaps open again. Climbing about 80 knots.
Alpha contact 126.05, good 8.
The reason why we're not getting a turn on course to our destination is they're trying to keep us away from Fort Lauderdale International's air. Arrivals and departures.
Fine.
So they keep you on an eastbound heading until we get clear of that.
All right, here we are leveling off at 3,000. We'll close up the cowl flaps. On the ground and through our climb, we keep the cowl flaps open to let a lot of that hot air come back out. That's when the engine's the hottest.
Okay.
But once we get into cruise, we have a lot of that air coming directly in those inlet holes, which it doesn't get during the climb. So it's getting cooled off enough. So we close up the cowl flaps and
keep the heat inside the engine. It's been many years since I've flown a small airplane like this.
Yeah.
You're reteaching me today.
So I'm just going to take the mixture out just about one finger length right now. Nothing technical because we're not at our final altitude. So we get the final altitude, we'll do a lean assist. So stable. I don't even have it on autopilot. It's just doing its thing.
I mean, today's conditions for flying, it doesn't get much better. And Mindy, you work for Cessna, correct?
Yep, I'm a sales director and demo pilot for Textron Aviation, which is Cessna Beechcraft Factory.
Oh, nice. Where are you based out of?
I'm based out of Atlanta at Falcon Field, south of Hartsfield.
There you go, guys. If you need a demo, go see Mindy up there.
So do they have to, like, officially clear us through the ATIS, or?
Yeah, since we filed our EAPIS with Customs, and we are cleared through the, across the ATIS, automatically, since we're on file.
Okay, and we got a squat code, like a discrete code, and we're on file, so we're good.
So they know who we are. So how long have you been a pilot, Mindy?
I started flying in 2012.
Wow.
So I've been flying for about 5 or 6 years.
A lot of fun, isn't it?
So much fun. I wouldn't do anything else.
As you know, becoming a pilot is time-consuming and very expensive. My friend Jason Shepard from M0A.com, he wrote a free book for everybody. All you have to do is pay shipping. It's the Private Pilot Blueprint. It's basically a guide to help you save time and money to get your private pilot license. Be sure to check it out. It's in the description below.
So this is a Cessna 182T model. The T model is just the model name. It's not a turbocharged, thermally aspirated. So the 2017 model, this has pretty much all the options you can think of, from storm scope to air conditioning in here, and it also has the new Garmin NXi.
That's nice.
119.45 for Charlie Foxtrot.
We're going to let Mindy take over the radios because
I thought you were doing radio.
She sounds a lot better on it, guys, than me.
Approach Skyline 774 Charlie Foxtrot with you climbing 6,100 for 7,500 on course.
November 774, Charlie Foxtrot, Miami approach, roger, continue your VFR climb on course. Continue on course for Charlie Foxtrot.
If we take a look at foreplay here, you'll see we have the synthetic vision pulled up along with, this is our routing today, we're direct to Bip. And over there, there's our runway numbers 10 and
28.
There's a lot of blue on our screens right now.
That's a lot of water, isn't it? We do have a life raft on board along with life jackets that we all picked up at the Banyan Pilot Shop there. It's a great spot to depart to the Bahamas because it's got all the supplies right there for us.
All right, so I'm going to put the autopilot on while we do our lean.
All right.
So we have a little bit of help. So this is the GFC 700. Basically, we had to pick two parameters for it to hold. In this case, I wanted it to hold our altitude, 7,500, and GPS, so it's holding our course the whole way to Bimini.
All right.
We're going to go to our lean assist. Basically, we're going to lean out the mixture until we get our peak EGT. Once one of those cylinders peaks, the peak number will populate and we'll get a blue box on top of the cylinder that peaked. Then once we hit the peak, we're going to enrich in it to be 50 degrees rich a peak. That's what the POH says the best way to operate it.
Nice.
And there's our peak. Now we'll enrich it. You can hear that engine difference. The mixture back in. And we're looking for negative 50.
Here, on the 145 contact Miami Center 135.6.
All right, so you got it all cruised out, huh?
We're at 145.
Just in time for us to land.
Yeah, I know, right?
So we're at 14.7 gallons per hour at 7,500 feet. And still gaining some of our airspeed, but we're about 140 on our true.
140 on the true, not bad.
Number 4, Charlie Foxtrot, what's your present heading?
140 for Charlie Foxtrot.
Spirit 301, turn right heading 140.
Right turn 140.
That sounds like they're keeping Spirit Airlines away from us. How nice. I'll tell you, Mindy, I don't know if you've ever thought about starting to do flight vlogs, but you may be the queen of YouTube if you start making videos.
That would be fun.
I think you do a better job than I do on these things.
I don't know about that.
So one thing we're trying out today, which is pretty exciting, is we're trying out the Epic Optics Eagle HUD. It's a heads-up display. It's full color, and what's really cool about it is it mirrors everything off of the your iPad. So right now I have it set up where I got it to the full synthetic vision where you can see through and that's what's displayed. If I wanted to just do a tap of the button and also put up my course and my other information, it's all projected on the HUD. Epic Optics is actually working with Textron, creating aftermarket products especially for the Cessna and Beechcraft airplanes, which is pretty cool. The price of this HUD is actually only $2,000, which is significantly cheaper compared to if you were to have an aftermarket HUD installed to your airplane.
So in our flight plan, I just put in that 3 miles from the airport I'd like to be at 1,000 feet, which is our traffic pattern altitude, and I put in a 700 feet per minute descent. We're kind of past the 500 feet per minute, which is what I normally pick, so we're
usually
about 2 miles from our top of descent.
Pressurized 500 feet is a good descent for your ears.
Right.
For being unpressurized.
Right, so we'll have a little bit steeper one today just because we're already approaching the airport so quickly.
We've got Bimini out there in front of us. Guys, I'm excited to announce Sun and Fun. We have a Steve-O One Knievo meetup at Bose on Friday at noon and Saturday at 4 Flight at noon. Be sure to stop by, we're giving out a lot of pilot swag. Also, we're going to be doing a big epic giveaway. It's a $3,000 prize package by Banyan. It's going to be linked in the description below. You go over to my website to sign up. Anybody can win, and we're going to be announcing the winner at Sun and Fun. We're going to be giving away the Epic Eagle HUD, along with a Stratus 2S, and a couple other little things in the package. So be sure to go to the steve1knievo.com, and just sign up for the contest, and we'll be drawing at Sun and Fun the winner. Very excited for that.
Approach 774, Charlie Foxtrot, would like to start descent.
For Charlie Foxtrot, roger, altitude at your discretion, contact Miami Center 135.6.
35.6 in altitude, our discretion, for Charlie Foxtrot.
We're looking for that traffic.
We want to check in with them while I get this stuff.
Number 8, Charlie Whiskey, additional traffic over decal, opposite direction, MOTI indicates 5,500, MOTI is unverified, and the type's unknown.
Radio Trail Whiskey.
Fine, good morning, November 774, Charlie Foxtrot with you, VFR descent out of 7,500.
November 774, Charlie Foxtrot, Miami Center, roger. Begin your descent now, please, for multiple jet traffic.
Roger, we're starting down now for 4 Charlie Foxtrot.
25.
We're going to go into Bimini today. We're going to, I think we're going to get a golf cart, go explore the island, South maybe Denver, find a Chowski good spot to get some lunch.
Maybe some conch.
A conch salad?
Yeah.
I heard they make some good stuff over here.
701, remain this frequency.
Observation, 15, 13, wind. 120 at 5.
November 8, Juliet, Juliet, cross decal 6,000.
Wind variable between
okay, cross decal 6,000, 768, Juliet, Juliet.
And
Chowski, 701, you on the frequency?
Visibility, moving. Sky condition, clear. Temperature, 2
Charlie
Celsius.
Wind, turn 10 degrees to the right, vector for that 5,500.
Altimeter, 3,
10 degrees right for that
1, 5 inches of mercury.
Silver Wings, 115.
All right, we got the airport information there.
Pick it up.
Start listening in on the Unicom, see if anybody's out there.
Good idea.
We're about 20 miles out, have the runway in sight right in front of us.
Thank you.
146.
Plan for runway 10?
Yeah.
The light wind out of the southeast.
50 for 60 and standby. November 8, Charlie Whiskey, contact Miami, approach 119.45.
Bimini is an uncontrolled airfield, so we'll be talking on a Unicom frequency.
Bahamas 201 to center, maintain 1212.
Basically, that's just all the pilots communicating together, so we all understand what we're doing.
Bahamas.
You know so much, it's almost like you're an ambassador there.
Okay. Actually, you say, Mindy, I think I'm becoming ambassador for flying for the Bahamas, for the Bahamian government.
You're a great fit for that.
So that is to come in the future. I will be a Bahamian ambassador.
November 774, Charlie Foxtrot, radar service terminated, squawk 1200, change to advisory frequencies approved.
1200, talk to you later, 4 Charlie Foxtrot.
Spirit Wings 237, stay out.
All right, well, that worked out good.
Okay, so you canceled us, right?
Yeah.
All right, so we'll squawk 1200. We got that set up. Now we're on our own. We can, we'll ditch Miami. Let's just go over and talk on Intercom. Yeah, this HUD is pretty cool. I've been enjoying being able to look and see all your information displayed right through the windshield. No, Mindy, I think we should do a little something cool. Instead of just landing, I say we go take a little flyby of this cool old sunken ship.
That'd be neat.
There's an old ship called the Sapona right off to the right of the island, and it's a great spot to go snorkeling. It'd be kind of cool. I'd like to show you.
Yeah, let's go take a look.
There's a few old airplane wrecks that you can go snorkeling on out here. And then you have the Sapona, the ship that we're going to do the flyby, and you can go snorkeling there, which is really awesome. This is exciting that I get to bring you over to the Bahamas for your first time flying.
Yeah.
It's not as hard as you think.
It's not. I expected it to be much harder. I'm going to kick off the autopilot and let's go circle around the ship.
That sounds like a plan to me. Have a little fun hand flying. I want the autopilot to have all the fun.
Right.
So you have Bimini off our left here, and then down just to the south here of us is Cat Key. There's a little runway strip down there that you can go to. It's pretty short. A lot of fun. I've been there a couple times.
North 2500, Treasure Key next.
Look at that color.
Isn't
that's
it?
Crazy.
Look at that. You can see all, basically you're just looking at the bottom of the water. Everything you see, it's all the different reefs.
It almost looks like a chlorine pool. It's so blue.
Yeah. Flying out here in the Bahamas, it just never gets old. Every time I come over here, it's just something that I love to look at out these windows. All right, so this guy's is the Sapona. This is the ship that was built around World War I. It was never used. And then during Prohibition, it was used to store alcohol, actually. And then during a storm, it ran aground right here many years ago, and it's been sitting here ever since. And it's a great spot to go snorkeling if you're here at Bimini. And as you can see, you got a sailboat and another little skiff down there. You're enjoying, you can go inside of it, snorkel around. You can even go on top of it, jump off if you're a daredevil. I haven't done that yet.
Yeah, jump off top of it?
No, I haven't. I'm actually afraid of heights. And standing at the edge of that thing, it's like 30, 40 feet in the air. Look at that. Nice view down there. It's really a fun spot to go snorkeling.
It looks like it's 6 inches deep. You can see right in through the water.
That's pretty cool. You can go snorkel down inside into the engine room area and all kinds of different places. All right, so that is the Sapona. All right, there we have our airfield off to our right here.
All right, I'm gonna get my first notch of flaps in below 140 knots. We'll go flaps 10.
All right.
And start getting our descent going. Bimini traffic, Skyline 4, Charlie Foxtrot on a right base for 10, Bimini traffic.
Runway
it does sound like anyone else is around. I don't see anyone else around. So I think the place is ours.
That sounds good.
You can see I have this visual set in, so we're going to have lateral guidance and vertical guidance. This glide slip's coming in now.
That is really a cool feature. We're going into a strip with no approach at all, and you're getting all that information. Very interesting.
And I'm going to get my next notch flaps in.
All right, no pressure, Mindy, but the whole world's watching this landing, but I got faith that you're going to nail this. That right out there in front of us is where we're going to be going. Right
oh,
over there.
Beautiful. As we turn final, I'm looking to try to be about 500 feet.
Okay.
And we're below 100, so I'm going to get full flaps in now. And I'm looking for about 65, 70 knots for our approach.
And we're all lined up.
That's no one.
On a 2 mile final.
Bimini traffic trailing 4, Charlie Foxtrot is on a 2 mile final for runway 10 Bimini.
And we're at 70 knots, and we're right on track.
Looking good. It's cool though, I see some big stingrays over here. You can't look. Oh, some sharks
oh,
too.
Oh, okay, I won't look.
You gotta pay attention.
We're flying out of here then. I wanna look.
That's why I'm enjoying being the co-pilot today. A whole bunch of sharks and stingrays. I'll fly the leg back so you can enjoy the view.
Yeah. All right, everything's full forward. We got all of our lights on. No one's on the runway. 200 feet. As we get closer, I know I have the runway made. I'll slowly start pulling this power out. Glide okay. Right in. I'm taking my power full out. I'm using my electric trim to kind of help me middle out.
All right. Nice. Not bad, Mindy. Thanks for a great flight. I'm used to being able to have a reverse in my airplanes that I fly, so
yeah.
I don't have to worry about braking as much. All right, guys. Welcome to Bimini, Bahamas. Mindy, thanks for having us on board and treating us to a good flight.
Thanks for showing me how to get here.
Yeah, no problem. All right, first step, let's go clear customs. All right, we just cleared customs. Piece of cake.
Yeah.
All right, let's go have fun and explore. All right, we got our van ride from the airport over, and next step is we get on a ferry to get over to the north side. Drop it like it's hot. Drop it like it's hot. All right, so our mission right now is we're gonna go tour the island and try to find a good spot for lunch. Drop it like it's hot. Drop it like it's hot. Drop it like it's hot. All right, Mindy, I think we found a spot for us to go eat.
Yes.
Joe's Conch Stand. First course, conch fritters. All right, in the main course, we got our gumbay punch and some fresh conch salad.
Cheers.
All right, we just finished up lunch at Joe's Conch Shack. Two thumbs up in my opinion.
Oh yeah, full.
We're gonna go explore the rest of the island. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. And if you did, please smash that thumbs up button, click subscribe, and we'll talk to you guys someday soon. Here's a little song I wrote. You might want to sing it note for note. Don't worry, be happy. In every life we have some trouble. But when you worry, you make it double. Don't worry, be happy. Don't worry, be happy now. Don't worry, be happy.